بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. Tonight, the 12th night of the month of Dhul-Hijjah, 1439 after the Hijrah of the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, which was the first day of the Ayyam al-Tashriq. So inshallah ta'ala, tonight will be the second night of the Ayyam al-Tashriq. So what is, alhamdulillah, also have khususiyah in regard to the Ayyam al-Tashriq is to be making the takbirat after the salawatul khamsa. To be making the takbirat, and these takbirat are known as yani at-takbirat al-muqayyad, the specific takbirat, and they are to be made after the five daily salawat, from starting from the day of the Salatul Fajr on the day of Arafah, all the way to Salatul Asri on the third day of the Ayyam al-Tashriq. So tomorrow bi-idhnillah will be the second day of Ayyam al-Tashriq. So after every salah that we make the takbirat Wednesday, so Thursday will be the last day of Ayyam al-Tashriq. Thursday after Asr, this is when, alhamdulillah, the takbirat will end, meaning the takbirat after every salawat.
That will be the last day. Today was the first day. Today is what? Today is Wednesday. No, Friday, actually. Friday. Right? Today is Wednesday. Yeah, Wednesday. So Wednesday was the first one. Thursday the second. So Friday will be the last day of the Ayyam al-Tashriq. Friday will be the last day of Ayyam al-Tashriq. So Friday after Asr, after that a person make the takbirat, after the taslim of Salatul Asr, he will not make it after the Salatul Isha. Huh? Yeah, he will not make it for Maghrib. He will not make it for Maghrib, nor for Isha. He will stop after making it for Salatul Asr. Continuing the reading of, and we're going to, alhamdulillah, take this sitting as a sitting of revising a little bit of that which were the last bab that we're still in, which is the bab fi wujub salat al jama'ati wa fadliha. The virtue of this bab deals with the obligation of the Salatul Jama'ah, the obligation of the congregational prayer and its virtue. The Shaykh Hafidhahullah, Shaykh Salih al-Fawzan, and as you all know, we're still reading Kitab al-Salah, the chapter of the Salah, or the book of the Salah, in that which is from the Mu'allafat of Shaykh Salih al-Fawzan, that could be found in Al-Mulakhas al-Fiqhi. Al-Mulakhas al-Fiqhi. In that chapter, which is the bab fi wujub salat al-jama'ati wa fadliha, the obligation of the congregational prayer and its virtue, we talked about, alhamdulillah, the different gathering that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has legislated for the ummah. Alhamdulillah, yesterday and the day before, that we have one of the gatherings, actually two gatherings, on the day of Arafah and the day of Eid. The gathering of Arafah, which is the greatest gathering, where everyone from different nationalities, from different backgrounds, from different ethnicity, from different tribe, and from different countries, they, alhamdulillah, all gather in one land, in one buqa'ah, in one place, which was on the Mount of Arafah. And all of them, alhamdulillah, sitting down and listening to one single khatib. Even those who did not go to Hajj, they were trying to listen to that khutbah. Because of this is the 1 year message that all of the Muslim, alhamdulillah, share. And after that you had the gathering of the day of Eid, Eid al-Udhiyah, which was a gathering that, barakallahu feekum, like the gathering of the Eid al-Fitr, the gathering of that yani that comes after the Eid festival, the Ramadan after the Ramadan, right? The Eid al-Fitr festival or the Eid al-Fitr celebration. And of course you have, alhamdulillah, the five daily gathering, right? That are from the five daily salawat. Now the Muslim, they gather. And they gather in their local masajid for their salawat al-khams, for their five daily prayer. You have likewise the gathering of the day of Friday, where the Muslims, they, alhamdulillah, go and attend the salatul jum'ah. And of course, after that, you have the gathering of the two Eid and the gathering, which is the greatest one, the gathering of the Hajj, the gathering of the day of Arafah. So also the Shaykh Hafidhullah, he mentioned about that which is the Salatul Jama'ah, the virtue of it. From the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned that the Salatul Jama'ah, he say that the virtue or the superiority of the Salatul Jama'ah over the Salah of one individual is of 27 darajat or 27 levels, 27 yani superiority virtues over yani the Salah of one individual. A person is praying by himself, his Salah is 27 times lesser, right, in virtue, in value, than the people that prayed in jama'ah. And also in another riwayah, bi khamsi wa ashara wa ashirin, of 25 virtue. So he mentioned, hafidhahullah, as in regard to the virtue of the salatul jama'ah, likewise, it is that a person go into the salah, all the steps that he will take, it is, alhamdulillah, of reward. And all other steps that he will take, it is also, alhamdulillah, of expiation for his sins. He take one step, it is of, from the reward, from the raising of his daraja. And he take another step, it will be, alhamdulillah, for expiation of his sins. And that you don't find it except, alhamdulillah, in going to attend the Salatul Jama'ah. Also, alhamdulillah, in regard to the verses, the adillah, proving the obligation of the Salatul Jama'ah. Sit down. Proving the obligation of the Salatul Jama'ah is, as Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, he mentioned Surah An-Nisa, and this is as known as the Salatul Khawf. The Salatul Khawf, the Salah in times of war. In times of war. Right? The Salatul Khawf, right? The Salatul Khawf in times of war. Allah Jalla alayhi say, wa idha kunta fihim. And here, the khitab is for the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but also, ya'ummu, it is also for everyone that is in the same takallufat, in the same obligation, right, of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. He said, "Wa'idha kunta fihim," and if you are with them, meaning being the leader of their army, he said, "Fa'aqamta lahumus salata," establish the salah for them. Tayyib, meaning you lead them in the salah. فَلْيَقُمْ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْهُمْ, let a group among them stand first. فَلْيَقُمْ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْهُمْ, let a group among them pray behind you. Right? And this verse, alhamdulillah, as the kayfiyya of the Salatul Khawf, it is pretty much a little different than the kayfiyya of the regular salawat. Right? How it is done. Number one, it is not the same amount of rak'at, right? Number two, it is that the person can make the taslim before the imam, right? But in the salatul jama'ah, the regular one, if you do that, your salah is what? Your salah is invalid. You make the taslim before the imam, Meaning, if you have the same intention as the imam, that's what you say. Because there are conditions or situations where the person could make taslim before the imam, and it will be correct. Right, Hassan? There are situations where the person can make taslim before the imam, and his salah is correct. What condition will be? Besides that, I'm talking about in a regular fi zaman al-amn, at the time of safety. Let's say a person comes in the salah, pray and make taslim before the imam, and his salah will be valid. What situation would that be?
Some danger around?
No, not there is no danger. It's time of alhamdulillah. He came to the masjid, bam, he prayed, Allah Akbar behind the imam, but he made taslim before the imam, and his salah is sahih. Hasan. If a person travel and he pray behind the imam, he cannot make the taslim just because he's a traveler. Whatever the imam pray for, you pray for. You're a traveler, you cannot, you have to follow the imam. It's different, no? Who's doing the Taraweeh?
The imam.
Okay.
Doing the Farid.
So what is the problem in there? What is the issue here do they have?
After your Isha is complete, you can just sleep while doing the Jamaat.
Why is that? Because? لِإِخْتِلَافِهِمْ النِّيَّةِ. Because of them having not having the same intention. If a person enters the Salah with a different intention, right? If a person enters the Salah with a different intention than what the Imam is praying, on that point on, it's permissible if you complete your intention to make the taslim. Mathalan, if a person comes and the Imam is making Isha, he came in with the intention of Maghrib. The minute he got 3 rak'ah, he can make the taslim. He can say assalamu alaikum and get up and catch up with the and then join them again with the intention of Isha. Right? So here, because they don't have the same intention. But if you have the same intention as the imam, there is no way that you can cut that salah before he finished the salah. Let's say, and even you find people, because of their traveling, they think that they pray two, and after they pray two, they will automatically make the taslim. Even if the person joined the imam at the second rak'ah, or ma'zira, at the third rak'ah, he joined the imam at the third rak'ah, right? So he prayed 2 rak'ah with the imam, right? And he is a traveler. He is not to make taslim with him. But rather, he got to get up and bring the 3rd and 4th rak'ah. Because the imam was made to be followed. إِنَّمَا جُعِلَ الْإِمَامِ إِلَّا لِيُتَمَّمَ بِهِ. That the imam was made except to be followed. إِلَّا لِيُتَمَّ بِهِ. That except he is to be followed. So this is, you find individuals sometimes, because they travel and they come, and they think that they have to pray too. No, you pray too if either you are being led by another traveler, or you pray on your own. But if you pray behind a muqim, then your salah has to be as complete as the muqim. But if you pray behind a musafir, that his amount of rak'ah will be your amount of rak'ah. You pray by your own, alhamdulillah, you pray as a musafir. Salatuhu sahih.
ممكن التسليم